sometimes when you're at home and you're watching the game and you're seeing the stadium, sometimes there's something going on, right? Someone's catching a foul ball or a whole section just disappears. Well, that's what happened last night. Section 42 cleared out as a swarm of bees came to the area. And you want to talk about unbelievable story, guys. Brian Grant was taking this game in himself, and he saw this happening, and he actually runs a company called Grant Boys Honey. So he asked for a box, came to action, and caught the queen bee in the box, which then attracted all the other bees. He stayed until the game was over. Fans were out at Truist Park to help remove the box of bees and got his own personalized jersey there.
That is fantastic.
Beekeeper from the Braves. I think this is just...
Did you notice his wife was way away taking a picture? That was awesome.
Yeah.
I would have been right
there. How ironic is
that,
though?
Yeah, that he was sitting above this section. Right. He saw what was happening.
Here's what's crazy, right? Big Joe and I were sitting and watching the game, and Big Joe says, why is the left field line so empty? Yeah. I'm like, man, I don't know. Like, it's like they've cleared out the section for some reason.
That's why I was saying, every time there's something, you see it, you're like, what's going on over there? We wanted you at home to know that's what was happening last night. And that very last shot, that is today, and some of the bees are back in that area, which was part of, apparently he waited around to take this box beyond 2 miles away, because if you don't, the bees will find their way back to the section.
Some of them are finding their way back. What is going on?
Who knew we'd be talking bees and baseball?
I don't like bugs, period. I would be scared.
Bees, BJ. It's the backbone of society. Without bees, we're not here.
We don't want to get into this right
now. I've got a 7-year-old
son. We're going to get into, as we've been talking about all day, guys, it's kind of the theme.
He's back.
That's right. Beekeeper.
He is saving the day. I see those bees out there.
I can't believe he wasn't in the production meeting.
Well, Truist Park last night was buzzing, quite literally. We had a bee outbreak. Thankfully, Brian Grant was at the game. He is the proprietor of Grant Boys Honey out of Monroe, Georgia. He is a beekeeper. He was able to restore order. The bees were safely trucked away from the ballpark. And Brian Grant is standing by with a guy that's always buzzing around Truist Park, Nick Green.
Hey, by the way, Chip, check this out. Turn around real fast. He's got the jersey, nice. So he's good to go. Hey, Brian, so you talked to us a little bit about yesterday. How did that all occur, and how did you become the savior?
Yeah, so I think it's the right place at the right time. You know, walking in, seeing some bees flying around. Not anybody didn't really know what was going on, so I thought I'd just jump in there and share some of our experiences catching bee swarms. And so got in there, and it worked out like it should.
So you've been to plenty of Braves baseball games. How does this game rank for you, being able to watch a baseball game and also save the crowd as well?
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I am a lifelong Braves fan. I'd say it's the top experience I've ever experienced out here at the Braves game, so it could have been a better outcome.
So we're going to see you again, hopefully at more games. But Chip, back to you guys, and I want to say no more bees today. I know Jeff has a lot to say about it since they saved his blueberries, but for us, we'll catch you guys later.
Yeah, Nick, tell him thanks. I appreciate being a bee guy with a blueberry farmer. Appreciate his work.
Jeff says thank you for your work because he's a blueberry farmer and he needs all the bees.
We'll bring him up there and take care of him for you.
He's got you covered.
There you go.
I have a better idea, Nick. Maybe we could just put Jeff in a pen with the bees and shut the door and see who wins. Well, that was a great story. Notice last night that whole section was empty. We were wondering what the heck was going on. We saw the box and the bees flying around. Brian actually came out of the stands and found the queen bee.
Yeah, that's what's impressive.
And then once the queen bee is safe, the rest of the bees follow. So that was really great. As we were joking too before the game, every kid comes to the ballpark and says, wow, I really love to get an autograph, or I'd like to get a foul ball. Well, Mr. Grant was the hero because he boxed up a whole bunch of honeybees and took them home.
I feel like we got to talk to Beth Marshall for the media guide next year. Get him in there. Official Braves beekeeper.
Well, we've got, let's just say we have sponsorships in 2021 we never imagined having.
Right.
Brian did a great job. Great sport. We appreciate him being such a great Braves fan. Monroe, Georgia, beautiful part of our state up near Athens. And as Avila takes outside, 2 balls, 2 strikes. What I didn't know was they say you have to take the bees far away from congregating. Otherwise, they come back, right?
It's like a dog.
Well, I mean, if you're saying a bee is like a dog, let's
no, exactly. You take them 2 miles off, they sniff their way back.
I didn't know
the strikeout. Tucker Davis.
I didn't know bees had snouts.
They do, apparently.
3 straight strikeouts for Davidson, 1 out in the 3rd inning.
I'm a blueberry expert, Chip. Just go with it, okay?
I'm with you. You know more about it than I do. I'm learning something every day.